Hello and welcome to this walkthrough of SWOOD Frames. SWOOD Frames design is an easy and efficient way to build customizable furniture and shelves. Let's start by creating a frame file in the task pane in the SWOOD library, and the first tab along is the frames library. To create a new folder, right click on the top level frames folder and select new folder. A new frame can be added to that folder by using the right click. Use right click once more and edit to begin customizing. This launches this frame assembly template, which contained default planes, offset planes, and a series of sketches helping to visualize the frame size. This template also contains custom properties, which control the height, width, and depth of the frame. These are altered using the offset plane distance or by using the edit frame tool found in our SWOOD design tab. The offset amount can be changed here, and this alters the size of the frame. The planes and sketches will update in the graphics area and help to visualize those changes. To begin creating a new frame, select the Create a New panel in the SWOOD Design tab. The first icon here will create a new panel in open space. To delete a panel, just use the Delete Panel command. That will delete any panels that's been selected. Between those two icons is the panel's positions tab, and a preview appears where we can select the panel we wish to appear in our graphics area in the context of our frame. In the graphics area, arrows will appear on the panel. Use these arrows and drag and drop them onto planes to create coincident mates between the panel and those selected geometry. This is what's defining the size of each individual panel. The gear symbol is the options. Here, the Insert Progress dialog's behavior is determined. This is also where default virtual components can be activated. If using the CAM or nesting side of the software, the advice is always to avoid this option to ensure a file path is present. At the bottom of this window are the shortcuts that can be used to save time and make it easier when inserting panels. Using Shift Select allows hidden faces to be selected and can be mated to planes as expected. Upon creating that fifth mate, the panel icon in the design tree turns blue, and this indicates that this panel is fully defined. Here, those mates can be selected, edited, or deleted. Another shortcut is the C key, which will automatically add coincident mates between the panel and any geometry that it is already coincident with. The panel arrows can also be dragged onto faces. This creates the coincident mate between the face and the panel. This ensures that the width of the already existing panels is considered when creating the frame. Points also appear that the arrows can be dropped onto. These points ensure that the coincident mate is between the panel and the intended geometry, as more than one piece of geometry can be used to create the same coincident mate. Holding Ctrl, selecting a panel and dragging creates a copy of the panel with mates. Panels can be renamed within the panel section of the property tab. Panels can also be left underdefined at this point and fully defined later, allowing for additional reference geometry to be created. Once the green tick has been selected, the Insertion Progress window will appear, which will indicate if there are any errors or issues within the panels. Whether this window closes automatically or not is defined within the options of the Create New Panel command. Additional reference geometry can be created and mates can be applied as expected in a regular assembly. Use coincident mates to keep the frame uniform and to fully define the panels. Additional panels can be added using that same new panel position command. Faces and geometry of previously created panels can be used for definition, but this is only possible if those existing panels have a material applied to them, which they should by default. As more panels are added, dropping the arrow onto that point becomes even more effective, ensuring that the correct geometry is being used. The custom properties contain the width, height, and depth of the frame by default. That said, other properties can be added to the table to allow for further customization. create a new property, and then use the graphics area to select the dimension that needs to be associated with that new property. All the properties found within that window will appear in the Edit Frame tool, allowing for efficient workflow when making changes to the frame. Finally, the SWOOD library can be used once more to apply materials to the frame. Select the material, drag and drop onto a panel, and then use the context toolbar to apply the material to the whole frame assembly or just the individual panels.